This tropical, coastal, mountain-encircled bay is home to a legendary lightning storm that has been going on for over 500 years. Hi, I'm Esther, and this is Minute Earth. Even though this legendary lightning storm is referred to as a single entity, it's actually a lightning hotspot. During daytime, the skies are clear. However, almost every night for as long as anyone remembers, a new lightning storm forms in essentially the same location. This isn't the only place in the world that's famous for its intense lightning storms. For example, Florida, which is often referred to as the lightning capital of the US, has a hotspot that gets 79 flashes per square kilometer per year. This means that a 1 kilometer by 1 kilometer area gets 79 flashes of lightning per year in the sky above it. For these 125 square kilometers, that's almost 10,000 lightning strikes every year, which is a lot of lightning, but not enough to make the top 10 lightning hotspots in North America, and very modest compared to Africa's top 10 hotspots, which range from 112 to 205 flashes per square kilometer per year. These lightning-prone places are located in tropical areas or near mountains, or are along coastal areas or near large bodies of water, such as lakes and bays. This is because some ingredients make lightning storms more likely to happen. The first is a lot of water. Then you need heat to evaporate all that water, and the tropics provide year-round consistent hot temperatures to get the job done. Then, this warm water vapor needs to rise and form storm clouds, which usually happens when there's colder air around to replace the rising moist air. This is why coastlines and large lakes are great places for cloud formation. During the day, the land heats up faster than the water, so the air above land moves up, generating an onshore breeze. At night, the land cools off faster than the water, and the reverse happens, generating an offshore breeze so that the clouds keep getting fed around the clock. Finally, mountains are another great way to force moist air up and generate clouds. Each of these features make lightning storms more likely, but what happens when you combine all of them in the same place? Well, you get the lightning capital of the world, Venezuela's Lake Maracaibo, with 232 lightning strikes per square kilometer per year. Lake Maracaibo, which is technically a coastal lagoon, provides huge amounts of water, is in the middle of the warm tropics, directly connected to the Caribbean Sea, and encircled by the Andes Mountains. As these mountains quickly cool off during nighttime, the water of the lagoon becomes comparatively warmer. The resulting offshore breezes converge directly over this warm water, generating powerful updrafts and storm clouds, the perfect conditions for lightning strikes. Which is why, night after night after night, Lake Maracaibo gets illuminated with the most striking lightning show on Earth.
Hi, this is Ever. I first learned about Esther from her amazing science TikToks. When I saw that she was interested in Catatumbo lightning, I thought it was the perfect subject matter for Minute Earth's visual style. So we got in touch, and the result is, well, the video you just watched. If you want to learn even more about Catatumbo lightning, Esther's got a longer video that dives even deeper into it. I'll link to that, and other places you can find her work, in the description. Thanks!